I've got my Regal RD 40 dobro here, and it is, I don't know a whole lot about these, very thin body dobro, traditional style Regal, and real thin back here at the back. And let's see here, I need to check, what is it, 3.5 inches there at the tailpiece. And there are D'Addario strings on it. It's got the import cone, import probably everything on this thing. And then it's got an interesting spider bridge on it. So what I've decided to do is I have a beard legend, an extra one, because everybody needs an extra beard legend cone laying around. And I just ordered a spider bridge number 14. And so I'm gonna put new guts in this thing and see what happens with it. And I'm gonna bring you along for the ride, just see how it goes. So what I did first of all is I've got my Blue Encore 100 mic that I really like recording dobro on, and I'm just gonna do this for so I can duplicate the recording. But I'm gonna put that mic about 5 inches away from, pointing right at that bottom sound hole. Seems to work okay. I know there's different places to put it. I'm just gonna do that just so we can tell. And so I'm gonna play this thing a little bit, and then we'll compare after we do the work to it. Very dead. It's really kind of sad how dead this dobro is out of the box. Like the speaker in a Geo Metro. All right, I'm gonna go do the work. I'll take you through that as well, and see what y'all think. Thank you. All right, we're back. And that didn't take very long. I was pleasantly surprised and kind of walked you through what I did. So I hope it wasn't too annoying to you. But anyway, basically took out the old import cone that came in the thing. Took out the old spider bridge, which I really wasn't familiar at all with what kind of spider bridge that was, and replaced it with a number 14 spider and a Beard Legend cone, which that thing is, I got to watch Paul Beard spin one of those, and it was pretty cool. In fact, I know on another one of my videos I talked about, I just put a hole in my wall. I talked about my gold tone. This is my gold tone. Isn't that pretty? For a gold tone, for sure. Solid mahogany, gold tone, Paul Beard signature. But he put that sweet cover plate on it, and then that's got a Paul Beard, and of course the regular number 14 spider that they put in them. And then he put the screenless sound hole covers in for me. It was well worth it. I mean, until I'm hoping to buy a Beard this year. I really like Paul Beard and his guys and his shop, and of course their guitars are amazing, and I know there's a lot of good guitars out there. But anyway, I think this just goes to prove a little bit to me. I'm excited to show this to you, but this just goes to prove that a lot of what matters about an instrument, especially a dobro, is the, or a resonator guitar, is the guts of it, the mechanics. And this still doesn't sound as good as the gold tone. It's plywood construction. You saw when I took that thing apart. I'd love to know what some of you think about that little whatever that was inside there. I'm not a luthier, whatever they're called. I don't even know how to say it, much less am I one of them. But I was really careful when I went through the process of doing it. I used StuMax resophonic guitar setup guide, and just tried to be real careful on leveling the spider bridge, making sure sanding the inside of this, the ledge there, so that everything's set smooth, and then make sure that spider bridge is perfectly level. Took a lot of time with the saddle. I did change the saddle to a maple and ebony. Surprised that this Regal actually came with a bone nut, so I didn't have to change that. And anyway, so I took the old, I did change the cover plate. This was the one that came on my gold tone. Man, that cover plate that was on this Regal was just really, it looked normal, but when I took it apart, it was really flimsy and just kind of junky. So put it on the Beard strings that I love, and put in some sound post around here to add support. There was a crack right here. I think I showed you on the video. So I added some of those sound posts. I didn't know what I was doing. I just was careful and used some, I think that's poplar. That's probably killing some of you guys that know what you're doing. I apologize, but that's what I had in my shop out there. And so I was careful to cut them to size and then glued them in place. And anyway, I know you don't really want to hear me talk. So here's what this sounds like. I think last time I said I was going to point it right at the sound hole here, but my mic kind of dropped and it's loose and I didn't take time to fix it. So I'm going to point it about the same as it was in the last video. And let you hear what this thing sounds like. I think it was a big difference. Here we go. I'll give you a strum here. Beefy, but I'm telling you, you can hear that legend cone, man. It's got some punch to it, and I love it. Too bad. Not a geo. We might have stepped up to like a Chevy, maybe. Sponsored by Beard or Regal or Reso Hangout. I can't get anyone to sponsor me. And I got 200 views on my last video, and I figured that would have somebody running to me. But anyways, I guess you gotta have more than that. Of course, I'm kidding. But hope you enjoyed this. I highly recommend that. Could be the best $100 you could spend on an instrument. Beard, well, excuse me. $140, $130, whatever it is. Beard cone, $80. I got this one for $50 on eBay, which was amazing. And then the Spider, number 14 Spider, and a new saddle. And this thing's, I think, sounding pretty good. I'm excited about it. Thank you all, and you have a good day.